The first thing you need to do is register your Clasp system. Inside the Clasp packaging, there is a small box that says Product Registration Card. Look inside there, pull out the product registration card, and on that card, you're going to see a product registration code. You're going to need that code along with the serial number. So let's go to the Endless Analog website here. Once you're at endlessanalog.com, click on Support, and then Product Registration. Okay, and here's where you fill in your product registration. You're going to want to put your first and last name, studio name, phone number, address, city, state, zip code. Put your country, pick an email address, pick a username, username 20 characters or fewer. Password, you need to use at least a capital letter and a numeral, at least 7 characters long. Here's where you're going to put your product serial number in. When you put your product serial number in, you want to make sure that you turn your caps lock on. So it needs to all be capital letters. So for example, here's the serial number, your registration code after that, the rest of this information, what kind of software you're using Clasp with, what kind of tape machines you're using Clasp with, your computer. Notification, this is important that you check this so that you get notified about any software updates that come out in the future. The last step is registration. Click the registration button and you're officially registered. If you get an error, just go back and check your fields, make sure you've got everything correct, and register again. Once you've registered the Clasp, then you'll be allowed into the downloads area. And you want to click on software. So here we have the RTAS plugin suite, VST for Mac, VST for Windows, and this is a manual in print PDF version. And the next thing you're going to want to do after you download your software is you're also going to want to download your MIDI drivers for your MIDI interface. So if you click on this link here, it's going to take you to the M-Audio website. You're going to first want to find out what Mac OS you're running. If you are running a Mac or a Windows PC, you're going to want to know what version OS you're running. In this case, we're running 10.7.2. You're going to want to click on MIDI Sport Series 2x2. Make sure it's not Anniversary Edition, but just 2x2. And then here you're going to pick your OS version. The most recent one they have for Mac is 10.6.8, 32-bit, which does actually work with 10.7.2. So you would click on this, and then scroll down, and then finally click on this. You don't have to fill out all of this information here. You can just skip this, go right to the bottom of the page, and click right here. And this will download the file for your MIDI interface. You're going to want to install this MIDI driver before you actually connect the MIDI interface to your computer. Once this is finished installing, it's going to ask you to restart. Definitely restart your computer. Once the computer is restarted, go ahead, plug in your MIDI interface, and then your MIDI interface is going to light up and start working.